My name is Nikita Nichols. I am 19. I live in Kalgoorlie.
My name is Alex Champion and I'm 17. And my people are the Gubbin and Wongai people from Kalgoorlie.
Wongai and Gubbin.
I'm Storm Cowlard and I'm 16. I come from Kalgoorlie and my tribe is the Jawan tribe.
My name is Tegan Rhodes Van Zonneveld. I'm 22 years old. I'm from Perth.
My name is Dakota Worrell. I'm 17 years old. I'm from Kalgoorlie, Western Australia, and I'm Noongar, Naju, Yamaji and Wongai.
I'm Noongar and Yamaji.
My name is Toshi Williams. I'm 16 years old, and I'm a Yamaji Wongai and a Barima.
My name is Kayla Banks. I'm from Leonora, and I'm 22 years old.
I live in Kalgoorlie.
My name is Amber Cowlard, and I'm 19 years old, and I'm from the Juban tribe in Kalgoorlie.
My name is Eunice Callion. I'm 19. I'm from Leonora. And my tribe is the Ongada Matul tribe.
I was born in Kalgoorlie. I moved to Perth. I lived there for about, 14 years. And I moved to Esperance in year 10.
Well, I'm currently year 12. I recently just got my license, so that's a big step of independence. And now my next thing is to graduate year 12.
A little town girl, doesn't know where to go, just lives in the moment.
Well, there's a lot of racism in our community, which I don't like, because when I walk in the shop, there's like people that stare at me and like look at me differently.
There's like a lot of drugs and alcohol going around and fighting around the community.
Younger children are sniffing and smoking drugs.
The main thing that's happening in the community is racism. A lot of it's affecting young Indigenous kids, and some people have lost family and friends because of racism.
I lost my cousin. It was a result in racism.
More young Indigenous kids are scared to ride their own motorbikes, to hang out with their friends, scared something bad's going to happen to them.
Yeah, what happened? Just disrupted the peace in our town.
I fear losing loved ones of my family because of all the things that are happening in Kalgoorlie.
The saddest thing in my life was when my grandmother passed away. Yeah, because she was really close to me.
The saddest moment would be when my mum passed away.
One of the saddest moments in my life would be going through child abuse, from sexual abuse, and losing my family through it. Having to feel like I'm the blame of it. And just losing all my family and feeling like the bad person. Just not being able to connect with my family from my dad's side, knowing that they hate me for what I've done, what I've come up with, and not being able to ever speak to them again. Yeah. I do feel stronger because I've been able to talk about it in front of people that I've only just met, and feeling like I can go further with it and just look at the good side of it and just keep walking.
One of the saddest moments in my life was when I lost my Nana Edna. She meant everything to me. And she taught me to believe in myself and I could do anything. And she taught me my culture, my language. And I miss her.
In my life, I've had a lot of loss. Getting past that is really hard.
For me, I feel like I need to do a lot more in my life because when I was with my ex, sort of control freak, I couldn't really talk to people. He really scared me. Like sometimes when I thought that I really want to leave him, but I was so scared then. And I was the only one working, so, and we got a house and I was working for that. It was just my pay and we still had to pay the bills and all that stuff. All he did was sit at home if I would complain about if their house was all like dirty and stuff. He would threaten me, and at one point we're like arguing, and then because he didn't like me talking back to him, he tried to choke me. I was so scared to leave him. I would never go out or nothing. I had no confidence in myself. I always felt ugly and all that stuff. That's why when I go into the shops and things, like, I feel like I have to cover up more. So I'm so scared of people looking at me and opening up to people. Because he put me down so much. It's helping me bring my confidence back, like talking to everyone and all the girls and listening to some of their problems as well. It's really helping. The message I would like to get out is just don't let people put you down. Don't make people feel you like you're nothing, like you're worthless to them, because there's always someone that loves you and cares for you.
The person who inspires me is my pop. He inspires me because he was a very hard-working man. He always fought for justice in the Aboriginal community. He helped me throughout my whole life. And he was very strong. He was very respectful to everyone. And he was a loving man. And he took care of everyone. And he'd never say no.
My biggest inspiration is my mum. My dad wasn't around much, and I guess she's taught me to be a strong young woman and to not rely on other people and to do good within yourself and push yourself to where and what you want to become. So I guess that she's my inspiration because she's shown me to be strong and keep going.
My biggest inspiration would be my mum because she's been a single mother for 5 kids. She's had a lot of problems with my father, not just physical abuse mentally. She always blames herself for the things that I've been through and something that she couldn't stop. So yeah, and she's still standing strong to this very day and still pushing through life for her kids.
My biggest inspiration would be my dad, because since he was 17, 18, he's provided for us since we were born and stuff, and he's only quite young when he first, but he's been working his whole life to give us the life we have now, and I really admire that.
My biggest inspiration is my mum, because she's got arthritis in both of her knees. She needs to get them replaced. She's been like that for ages, and when I don't want to go to work or I don't want to do anything, she encourages me to go for it.
My biggest inspiration was my Nana Edna. She did a lot for us kids as we were growing up. She taught us everything to know about the bush and how she used to live. She had lots of stories to tell us, and I just wanted to be like her.
My old mum, she's like a hard-working woman. Like, she doesn't let anyone, you know, go without anything. She has to get up and do it.
My biggest inspiration has to be my mum, because she supports me a lot, and she told me to get out to do this. And yeah, I'm happy that she did. Be who you are. Nobody can take that away from you. Oh, straight from the heart. No playing games. You gotta be true, true, true. You gotta be.
When I first came in, like, I was shy, I didn't really know anyone.
When I first came into the program, I felt really shame. Didn't really know anyone.
I didn't really believe that I could do it. I didn't think I had many good qualities and didn't think I'd come this far.
What's it gonna bring out? You know, what am I doing? What am I getting out of this? And just feeling nervous, shame.
At the start of the program, I felt shame. I didn't want to do most of the things that they've done.
And now, like, yeah, I can talk to everyone, like, outgoing, like, show my personality out to everyone.
Now I feel a bit confident in that I can make people laugh and smile.
It's taught me how to believe in myself that I can do it and just build my confidence and believe in myself. My personality has made everyone happy and just, yeah, feel good.
I just am more comfortable around the girls and everyone that's in the room.
Now it's like I want to join in and do a lot more.
Yeah, I think I've improved a lot on my confidence and changed my ways and just became a better person in general, I guess. Feel happy, good about myself.
I feel happy about myself because of the program that I've done. Before, I didn't really feel as happy as I used to, and now I feel really happy and good about myself.
The best thing about these workshops is they build on my confidence. They help me to be comfortable in my own skin.
Yeah, I feel proud of myself by doing this here, because I thought that I never end up trying out to do this.
I am happy because I'm starting to be proud of myself, because I'm getting out there, I'm meeting new people, I'm doing things for myself for once.
Since I've been part of the program, I feel a bit more confident and yeah, happy.
The biggest challenges of this program is talking to everyone, because I don't really talk to people outside of work or home.
My challenges at the start were finding friends, because never really got out there, never socialised, and I was in my own bubble, so yeah.
During the workshops, the biggest challenge were speaking out loud.
I'm doing it with my sister, so that's really fun because I've got someone to do it with.
Some of the challenges I've faced personally, at the start, just like introducing myself to all of the girls and just trying to come out of my comfort zone, which I did.
Most enjoyable thing this week would probably be getting all of our makeup and hair done for our photo shoot.
My favourite workshop was the voiceovers, because it's telling our stories in a way and just getting it off your shoulders.
The things I enjoyed the most about the workshops are everything, just meeting everyone, talking to new people.
My favourite workshop's been the photo shoots, just putting on makeup and doing ourselves up and then getting in front of the camera.
My favourite workshop would be the beauty one, the personal development one, which is like, and we all just have a laugh and we get to like paint our nails and wash our faces and stuff. And yeah, it's fun.
My favourite thing was Tika showed us with the balloons. Like, you can't hold your struggle by yourself. Like, you have to get someone to help you.
The best thing about the workshops is joining in with other girls, yeah.
Meeting the new girls, the girls, and being connecting with them and making friends for a lifetime, and yeah, just building my confidence as well.
The confidence building for all of the girls. You can see how they've changed.
Coming together, like girls are sitting around at lunch and wanting tea, and it's a good experience because we get to talk to each other and people that we would never talk to. So like, we come together, we speak to each other and act like we're sisters.
If I had an opportunity, I'd like to go overseas to visit other countries.
I would love to travel right now, go see the world and what it has to offer.
I hope to achieve being a young business owner. I would like to set up my own home business in beauty and hopefully go from there.
I would really like to be a dental assistant. That'd be really fun. I've just had an interest in it. Or I would like to go on the mines to be a dump truck driver.
I would like to travel, like take my sisters with me, like to different places, because one of my sisters, like, she doesn't really get out and do much. Take her with me everywhere. She's just like, me and her are like so close.
It's just a good experience to be a part of, so I'm glad I'm a part of it.
I worked a lot to get here.
Ever since I've done this and got this far, I feel so much happier with myself and feel so much more confident and feel so much more outgoing.
I love this program. It makes girls believe in something, that they can be anything they want. It helps grow their confidence and their self-esteem.
I would encourage more girls to come to Goldfields Girl and give it a try.
The message I'd like to give to the young girls is, like, it doesn't matter what size you are or how tall or short you are, you can get out and do something for yourself.
Stand up, be a leader, and to get other young Indigenous women to stand up as well with you.
Be yourself and don't follow in other people's footsteps. Go your own way.
And just like push forward, because when you push forward, you can lead up to your dream.
Don't be ashamed and don't always blame yourself and hide your feelings inside of you.
Don't be ashamed of who you are.
Don't let anyone tell you that you can't do it, because you can show them wrong every single time.